Hello everyone. I want to give you an introduction how PLM change management is handled in SAP S/4HANA. The following functionalities are available in S/4HANA on-premise, starting with release 2020 FPS1, as well as in cloud systems, starting with S/4HANA Cloud Edition 2011. In this video, I want to give you an overview how the setup of change record types is working. I will first show some slides and then jump into the system for a live demo. Please note that we have used the latest S/4HANA on-premise system, which is currently shipped to our customers. It has the state of S/4HANA 2021 FPS0. The setting up of the change record types is mainly part of the basic settings when setting up your system. Change record types are putting all the different kinds of functionalities together into one framework. Therefore, you need to think about your business processes before you decide which kind of functionalities you want to cover for which change record type. One of the first points is to setting up a number range. The change record number ranges are defined in another customizing table. The mapping between the change record type and the number range is then happening in the change record customizing table. I will show this relation later in the demo. Secondly, you need to assign your record type to a status profile. How to set up a status profile I will show in another video. The connection of status networks and change record types is also happening in our customizing table. The next setup is the checkbox of the processing status. If the processing status is set, then the processing status needs to get maintained on the change record item level. How this is working and what kind of different processing status we have available, you see on the following slide. So in a change evaluation, where no change number has been generated, we are able to set the processing status from initial to change possible, change unnecessary, or change impossible. In case processing status impossible is set, the system does not allow us to push the change record for approval. With a processing status of change possible and change unnecessary, we can push the change evaluation into a change execution and can then set the processing statuses of change started, change completed, error in change, error corrected, and change released. The connection between the different processing statuses is showing you in the diagram. The fourth point is the decision of which kind of workflow you want to use. To have the latest functionalities available, we recommend using the process route. With the process route, you can use sequential and parallel tasks, as well as templates, which can be manually or automatically loaded. The alternative would be a so-called flexible workflow. A flexible workflow scenario can be also set on change record type level. As next, we also have the PO flag available. If the PE and O flag is set, then the impact analysis of PO gets used instead of the change record impact analysis. When using PE and O, SAP also recommend using the flexible workflow since process routes are currently not available in PO. If the PO flag is set, you will also see the respective change record type in the PO-related apps, like for example, managed unassigned EBOMs. Lastly, you can also decide on the output of a parallel change check. The parallel change check is giving out a message in case one change object is assigned to multiple change records. Via the dropdown, you can decide if in this case a parallel change information, warning or error message should throw. By selection of a change record type, you can also have a closer look into the related customizing structure. In this structure, you can dive into the selections of the change record objects, the item relevance, dynamic field control, the change number handling, as well as the settings of the digital signature, the impact analyzed scenarios, and settings for merchant splitting. All these topics you see on the customizing structure, we will have a more detailed look in our upcoming sessions, so stay tuned. Let's now jump into the system to have a closer look into the setup of our change record types. To open the customizing IMG, please use the transaction SPRO. Opening this, you will then find the change record customizing under the structure of Logistics General, Product Lifecycle Management, and then Change Records. Under this structure, you have all the single folders available. The main setup of our change record types is happening in the structures of the setting for engineering changes. In there, we are mainly playing in the IMG activity of defining engineering change record types. Opening this customizing table, you have here all different types of change records available. By the button on the left-hand side, you can also switch between display and change mode. If you want to add new entries to this table, you need to use this button. If you want to copy existing lines, you can use the third button. If you want to delete single change record types, you can use the fourth button. So as already mentioned, every line here in this table stands for a separate change record types. So the first column, there's the short term of these change record types. Normally these are three characters. In the second column, you can give the change record type a description. In this system, we now have these following 12 change record types available. These change record types you will also see in the Fiori site when you're clicking the button of Create Change Record. Here you see that you have exactly the same change record types available, what we see in customizing. The next column after the description, you are setting up the change record number range. Here you are defining which number range your change record should get. The number range is set up in another customizing table. So if you go back to our change record customizing structure, you're going into the basic settings, and then the first entry, define number range intervals for change records. Opening this, you can display and create different kind of number ranges, and you can also create new ones. These entries of the number range you then can select here via the F4 help in this window. The next topic is the status profile. How the status profile gets set up, we will have a separate session for it. Here you see that you can select different kind of status profile to different change record types. The selection is also happening via the F4 help. What I also will quickly show you is where the main customizing for the status profile is happening. So this is happening in our structure of the user status. Here you have several customizing tables available where you can define your status profiles, which we are selecting in our change record type customizing table. To check these two settings on the change record type, you see here our number range, which we have assigned to the change record type of PIC. The status network you will see here in this field. Also, the progress start is showing you a more detailed overview about the whole status network. In the next column, you enable the item browsing status. The item browsing status can be easily switched on and off via this checkbox. To show you the browsing status in the system, we're switching into the edit mode of a change record, adding an item, for example, a material. And then we see Via this column of the browsing status, you can set the different browsing status which we have available in the system. When we are switching off this checkbox, saving the customizing, and going back into the system, you will see that we do not have such column available. The next option is to set the process route. So also in this example of our PIC, process industry change, the checkbox of the process route is set. If we are unchecking this checkbox and saving the customizing, we will then see that the process route is no more longer enabled for the change record type. If you use the flexible workflow instead of the process route, so this means you are unchecking this process route checkbox, you can also assign a flexible workflow scenario to your change record type. This is set up in the next column. Like you, for example, see on this change record type MFG, a flexible workflow scenario is set. As already mentioned in the presentation, we recommend you to use the process route to have the latest functionalities available. As next, we have the column of the PO relevant flag. So as already introduced in the presentation, if this flag is set, like for example for this MFG type, then this change record is linked to the PO applications, as well as the impact analysis of PO is used. In addition, we also recommend you to use the flexible workflow if the change record is connected to PO. Last but not least, we have this parallel change check available. So via this dropdown, you can select if a change object is assigned to multiple change records, what kind of message you want to receive from the system. You can select between no message, a warning message, an information message, or an error message. In case you selecting the warning message in the dropdown and saving the change record, you can then jump into the system and see how this behaves. In the edit mode of the change record, you can add an additional line item. And then you see that this warning message occurs. If you are changing this warning message to an information message and save the customizing, if you do exactly the same what you have done before on the change record at the same material, and then you will see that in this case only an information message is thrown. As already mentioned, this can not only be changed to an information or warning message, also an error or no message can be thrown. Back on our customizing table, we now having a look into the rest of the structure of this customizing table. We can dive deeper in it when we are selecting one change record type. And then we see that, for example, what kind of reference objects are attached to this change record type. Also, we see which item relevance we have available for the different change record types, as well as the dynamic field control settings, the change number handling on header level, as well as the change number handling on item level. We can make the setups for the related record type for our digital signature strategy. We can set the impact analysis default scenarios. And lastly, the merge and split setting is also happening in this dialog structure. Please note that for all these topics you see here on the customizing structure, we will have a more detailed look in our upcoming sessions. So thank you everyone. I hope I give you a first overview how the setup of different change record types is working. You should now get a first overview what kind of different functionalities you can set on a change record type level.